Hello everyone, we are learning complete PHP course and today we are going to learn string method. String method is really very easy and very useful in our project. So let's start. Start quickly. Comment string method. So first method, very quickly, first one, how to check length. So string length, the first method, how to check length, right? Very easy, str len. Just you see here str len, and here in bracket you have to write your variable name. For example, this is my variable name. And don't forget, when you want to create variable, don't forget dollar sign. So it's equal to Rajesh semicolon. So let me print echo. Let me show you first name here. You see, already started my local server start. So just going to write localhost php, because my php means my folder name, right? See Rajesh. So now I am going to use this method and the check length. Length means just let 1 2 3 4 5 6. So if you want to check length, just make bracket here first, bracket, and then I want to write here str len. Don't forget, and you see here color is different, right? Not like this one. So let's run here 6, because our length is 6 here, you see, totally 6. So if you want to check length, you have to write str len, means string length. We use this one in our program, in our project. So I will show you how, when we are going to use this one. Very useful. And here space means when you write this space, is going to count one length, Kumar Yadav. So 6 and 5, 11, 11 and 5, 16, and one space here, 17, one space here, 18, right? So let me show you 18. Understand, right? So this one, how we can check string length. This one is really very useful, and I'm teaching you this method. Is really, really very useful in our project, real life project. So when I start project, I'm not going to tell you again what is str, because you guys already know here, right? So this is first method. So second method, make comment first, second method, how to count our word. So for that is also very easy. Just you have to write str underscore word underscore count, and here you have to write variable. Just if you want to count is, for example, 1 2 3, okay? So let me use this method. Just going to copy from here, I'm going to paste here, same way, right? Just variable is here and variable is here, same. So our answer is 1 2 3, correct? So you 3. What about if I want to put more here? For example, I'm going to space here. Now you see 1 2 3 4, correct? So if you want to count word, then that time you have to use this method, str word count. So now time for method third, a theory method, how we can replace any word. Before replace, let me tell you how you can use reverse method. Reverse method means print from here, from back side. So for that, it's same like this one, very easy. So for reverse, very easy, just str rev reverse, and here variable name. So I'm going to use this method here, str reverse means re and see color v, You see color is different, right? Correct. So this is, this method is going to print this variable, means this sentence, right? From back side, means from back side here. Let me show you here quickly. You see my name here, right? But from back side, from here, y a d a b a d a y, see, b a d a y, and the r a m u, r a, you see, r a m u k, right? So from back side, if you want to print from back side, you have to use str and rev, means reverse. If you want to check length, you have to use str length. If you want to count word, then you have to write string str word and count. And don't forget this one. If you forget this symbol, your answer not going to print anything, I'm going to show you error. So this one is third one. Let me last one, fourth. How you can replace? So if you want to replace any word or anything, then you have to use this method. Method is very easy, just str replace, and here you have to use like this. For example, first, for example, I'm going to give you first Kumar, and the second Rajesh. So here Kumar is going to replace with Rajesh, okay? And here I'm going to print my whole name or anything what you want to print. For example, Kumar Rajesh. So what do you think answer? If I print like this, what is your answer? So what do you think about answer? This Kumar is going to replace with Rajesh. So that means going to this Kumar is going to replace, right, with Rajesh. That means this is Kumar is going to replace with Rajesh, and this Rajesh is going to print Rajesh. So our answer is Rajesh. This one is Rajesh, and this one also Rajesh. Okay, because this one is going to just using for replace method. So let me show you the same example. Copy from here, and let me paste here. Let me paste here, and I'm going to make bigger this one. And here, don't forget echo. Oh my. Don't forget here echo. Okay. Then let me show you. Rajesh and Rajesh. This Rajesh. Why want to print this Rajesh? And how we print this Rajesh? Do you know why? Because we want to print this one. And these two for just a replace method. So this Kumar is going to replace with this one. For example, let me give you another idea, another example. Rajesh. Kumar. Rajesh Yadav, not Kumar. I'm going to write a simple one. And this R, I'm going to make capital. So for that, I'm going to write here capital R, and here is small r. Here is small r. So you understand what? This small r going to replace with capital R, where? In this sentence. So this r going to replace with capital now. Let me show you. You see, it's capital, but here our answer, this one is small, right? Why is going to capital? Because this one is going to replace with, this one is replace method. So this is going to tell what? All small letter r, that small r is going to become capital R, where? In this sentence. For example, I want to use one more r here, so let me show you here. See, this one is also capital, because this method is going to change all small letter to capital letter, correct? So this is four method we are always going to use in our project. So I will show you in our project everything step by step. So I hope you guys understand this video. If you guys understand this video, please like, comment and share with your friend. If you have any problem, just SMS me, email me or contact me on my Facebook. I'm always here for help you. It's really useful for you guys, so you have to learn these things. So see you in next video, next lecture.